Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and in our Illustrator Facebook group, we sometimes get a lot of really good Illustrator questions, and here's one. One user asked, I bought a PNG file and I need to add cutting lines to it. I know how to trace a PNG in Illustrator, but it doesn't pick up the original white border. How can I get Illustrator to include that white border on the image? So this is what I'm going to show you today. All right, let's get started. All right, so I'm here in Adobe Illustrator, and I have a PNG file here. If I move it off the screen, I'm just gonna go ahead and work on it over here so you can see that white outline. When we image trace, usually Illustrator will just ignore this and it'll put the line right here. So it's going to ignore the white. To show you what I mean, I'll just image trace and do 16 colors here. And if we expand and then remove the white, this is what we get. It's basically just taken off the white outline. Okay, I'm gonna undo that. So how do we get it to keep the white outline? Okay, so first I'm going to copy this and then paste in front with Command F or Control F. And now we have two copies, one right on top of the other. I'm going to hide the top one. I have it selected and I'll hit Command 3 or Control 3. So now we are working with the underneath layer. With that bottom one selected, I'll go to Edit, Edit Colors, Adjust Color Balance, and then I'm going to change my color mode to grayscale, and I'll convert. I'll make sure preview is checked here, and then I'm going to put this all the way up here with my black at 100%. So now it's capturing that white outline. I'll say okay, and then I'll image trace this. I'm going to choose a little drop down by the image trace button here. And by the way, if you're not seeing this, this is under window control, this little bar. It changes based on whatever you have selected. So I'm going to click this little drop down and I'll choose black and white logo. And then I'm going to expand up here. Now I'll hit Y on my keyboard to get to my magic wand tool. I'll click the white and hit delete. And then I'll hit Shift X to switch to a stroke only. Now I'm going to change this to a cut line. To do that, I'll go to Window, Layers, and open those layers up. I'm gonna make a new layer, and then I'll click right on that blue dot. This shows the selection. I'm just gonna drag everything that's selected onto that new layer. Okay, so now we have just the outline on that new layer. I'll make sure that my stroke is in front right over here. I'll add a swatch in my swatches panel. By the way, all your panels are going to be under window if you're not seeing them. I'll choose new swatch. I'm going to change this to a spot color. I'll change from grayscale to CMYK. And then for the magenta, I'm going to change this to 100. We'll put the black at 0. And the swatch name should be cut contour with no spaces. And I'll say okay. Okay, so our cut line has been created. Now we can bring back our design. So I'll go to Object, Show All. And now you can see the cut line goes all the way out to that white outline. One thing I usually do with a cut line is I'll just round those caps and corners just to make it a little more smooth. And that's it. If you have any questions or comments, please leave those in the comment section below and I'll try to help you. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.